Welcome back, viewers. Today we're gonna do Spec Group's task 17 and 18. More specifically, going to be do the elites and then do Epic Green Goblin. Oh, sorry, yeah, Epic Yellow Jacket. I mean. Also, if the volume is correct, please put that down in the comments. I've been having some feedback that the volume was quiet, so I upped it up a fair amount. So I hope it's good now. Okay, without further ado, let's go in. Just do the deploy here. See how it looks. Okay. I've been heard. Ah, there we saw. Two roads to the... I wonder which one is the epic one. There we go, epic boss there. Okay, so we see how where to go. So I'm gonna go left after this. As you can see here, I'm trying to do the trials for my Anula. So I'll put her in here, see how it goes for her. See if she can bring it or not. So I'm going at Spec Ops here without a tank. All of them are wheeled, so we'll see what happens. See if they can take the heat. I need to defeat infiltrators and tacticians and do bleeding on her and stuff like that. So let's do that. So far, the Spec Ops has been pretty fun to do actually. I have no complaints at all, and it's been you know, pretty bug free. Okay, let's apply demoralizing shout so she gets ready. So she applies, I hope, and I think she applies bleed twice. With her regular basic attack is bleed, the one with readied. We'll see when I attack. Actually, I'm gonna leave it there so she can hit with the bleed attack. Vital slash. Okay, let's see what happens now. It's gonna be interesting actually. Personally, I'm looking forward to getting Ant-Man. People like him a lot, apparently. I've seen him around a fair amount in PvP and in videos and comments as well. So gonna be interesting to see if I like him or not. Probably will. Since we have a interesting toolbox. So far though, you know, I've been having Anula for a long time, so I haven't done anything with her, so I decided to bring her up a bit, at least to 3 stars. Just to get that done. So far, she hasn't been let me down, but since she's only 1 star and no stars on her extra on her abilities, she's not been, you know, really doing a lot either. Let's apply some bleeds before this wave is over. Okay, now let's see. Does she apply bleed? No. Okay, her basic attack from Reddy did not apply bleed. That's good to know. I'm gonna put that one on then. So one less bleed attack applied. This, I really hate this man. Why can't they show us what we got? It's like a guessing game, and then you have to go through your ISOs afterwards, and it's like, okay, I have no clue if I got a new one or if I just missed that I had this one later on. Okay. I think it's... Oh, nice. I think it's... Let me see. Which one was the epic one? I think it was the one with Militant. Oh, actually, it was not. It's the other one, actually, here on Hydra. Okay, let me just check the tasks. For the spec groups. Yeah, 4 out of 10. So this should probably do give me 10. I read that it, if you do the 3 Hydra before, you get enough to get 10. So you're perfectly positioned for the last task before you do the epic yellow jacket. And I'm gonna exchange for Groot for epic yellow jacket. I think I'm gonna need it. Excuse me. Okay, so far I haven't been a problem actually going without a tank in the spec groups, quite surprising. You think you would need a tank, but no, it's no heroics. Actually a lot easier. So, how do you guys like Anula? She seems to be very popular due to her impetuous cleave and good stats. So far, yeah. I haven't really seen the super damage from her. But of course, I'm not using impetuous cleave right now, so. And she's low star, so she's not killing anybody, so she doesn't get to go again, etc. etc. It's like a up and down pyramid. The better it gets, the, you know, like this up and down. The higher up you get, the more oomph you get. So, yeah, because I actually got to borrow a 4-star Anila from an ally, and it was pretty slick. I ain't gonna lie, it was pretty nice actually. I was using that in Heroics 3-6, and she performed. Definitely, I can't complain. See what kind of stats I have on her right now. 3600 attack, 3300 accuracy, 3600 evasion. Pretty good. But, you know, she's only 1-star, so she's missing 600 on all her stats from 4-starring her. That's a lot. So far, it seems to go pretty swimmingly here, actually. Not a problem. We'll see once we get to Epic Yellow Jacket. I haven't actually faced him yet, so that's gonna be interesting. Let's do this one. Just because I want to see how it works, how much damage it does on a free attack. Of course, he just did a debuff attack, so I didn't get a free attack. Oh well, oh well, oh well. Black Panther taking care of business as usual. Same with Black Widow. I wish they would put in another black character, man. Black name, the super hero. So I can go totally black. And again with the ISOs. Show it to me. I want to know what I'm getting. And good God, please let me remember to actually update my task list. After this Hydra engagement, so I don't by mistake. okay, didn't I get the deploy here? Deploy? There we go. Weird. So I don't by mistake forget to update the task and then head into the epic Yellow Jacket fight. That would suck. I wouldn't suck that much, just 100, you know, energy or so, but still. Okay. Okay, that was not a lot of damage. Okay, it seems that the fight is starting to go up in levels now. Ouch! Almost took out my Angela with one blow there, took it down to half. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna bleed you to death! Don't trust anything that bleeds every round. Okay, alerted is up, so it's time to go to work. I'm unfortunate of having Anila. I know there's people who have spent lots of gold trying to get her beyond the rumors that you can get the PvP characters from. From the superior power cells. So basically, I have all the PvP heroes except Miles. I took a break there, I only got down to like 15 in rank before I took a break there, so I missed him. I should have gone up to F5 at least. That was just stupid. I just forgot about it. I had a lot of stuff to do. So, oh well. It happens. But you know, free heroes are free heroes. And I definitely recommend everybody to go up to at least rank 5 in PvP because it's a free hero, why not? And you get all those power cells as well, it gives you juicy stuff. Okay, now she's down. You get all the power cells, it gives you all the juicy stuff, the ISOs, the abilities, shield points, all the good stuff, man. Definitely get it. Okay, so far so good. Haven't had a huge issue here. Besides Angela going down, but you know, I kind of expected it earlier actually, with how without me running without a tank. So definitely expected that to happen earlier. But yeah, she survived pretty good. Ain't gonna complain. Slowly but surely getting her up on the trials. Probably gonna do a Groot character spotlight next, because as you can see, it's my preferred tank. At least until they put out a tank and not a tank that can actually compete with Wasp. And to be fair, Groot is not as good as Wasp, but since I dislike Wasp, so Groot it is. And he had a pretty good run before they nerfed him, sadly. as you can see, I have 3-starred a lot of his abilities, his protection, his bark skin, everything. I used him to get out... let's just take him out instead. I used Groot and War Machine and Iron Man, actually, to get through 3.6. I call the team the Bubble Boys. And I actually had to run 4,000 defense on both Iron Man and War Machine. Because I noticed that glass cannons didn't really work well. Because one hit and they were out. 4,000 defense plus the bubbles they had from War Machine's ability and from Iron Man's tactical took care of most of the damage. So I didn't really have to put recover on that much. And before, Groot's recovery lasted was put on all of the team. So shields and recovery, good enough. Now, though, no, only one person. So I don't actually understand why they did that, since Groot was obviously far inferior to Wasp at that time. So she just left him as he was. Okay, it's looking like we're done here now, and we're probably gonna face Epic Yellow Jacket now. I'm gonna update my task list here. Yeah, here we go. Cream of the crop. Ooh! Wee! 4-star purple. Oh my god! Thank you. Finally. And 3-star red. Yeah, I have lots of 4 and 5 stars, but finally a purple Isoman. Oh my god! Thank you. Thank you. Ah, the joy, man. The joy. Okay, not to forget, update the task list. So I don't forget it in my joy. I'm just reading in the text here a sec, since it's the first one I've seen here. Okay, let's collect the deploy. Of course, crap, ISO man, really, it's like really, Taiwan ISO. Okay, the task, claim. Okay, and the new task is defeat Epic Yellow Jacket. And then I get, okay, permanent access to Spec Ops 1. Matter and Antmatter, lol. And of course, Ant-Man. Oof, no, finish now. Okay, let's go guys, shall we? Okay, I'm actually gonna put in Groot now from the start. Oh, it's only one wave. Okay, how hard can this be? I'm gonna take out Angela as well, just in case. Put in some serious deeps. I'm gonna go with Age of Ultron Hawkeye. It only costs 15 energy for the Epic Yellow Jacket on the Spec Ops. That's crazy, man. I'm used to 50 from the Heroics. Oh, wow, that's really crazy. Yeah, I might do this again, actually, because, you know, the ISOs was crazy. I've read that the first time you do Mission 1 and 2 and 3, you get better rewards as well. Might be true. Every day. So I'm gonna go into Mission 1 later on. Okay, he had not the boss here with him, Crossfire. Okay, first up, Panther's Grace, buff up the evasion, and then Black Widow. See if she takes care of business. No, they are actually pretty tough, apparently. Sweet. Black Panther dodged Crossfire Snipe. And Black Widow dodged Yellow Jacket's attack. And now, Barkskin, 50% less damage, thank you. Okay, now time to go to work. Let's take out Crossfire first. I don't like his debuffs and snipes and stuff. Oh, nice. 3700 crit on his face from Black Panther. And we'll see if Black Widow can take care. Nope. Only 800 damage. Yeah, she's not doing that. She's not bringing the pain. My Black Panther is bringing the pain here. Which I'm very thankful for. See if he can take out Crossfire now. Nope, he didn't because he's left stealth, sadly. Okay, let's actually guard now. Or protect. Since my Groot still has blocking up, unlike my Black Widow and Black Panther. Okay, Crossfire is gone. Now only Yellow Jacket left. To be fair, it wasn't that hard so far. Been pretty easy. You know what? Let's go back in stealth next round. I just needed some stamina. Okay, put up a shield here on Groot, just so he can take the bashing here. Okay, now let's go back in stealth. Never want to leave stealth with Black Panther. Okay, he took out the whole shield on Groot. Really? Oh my god. Okay, that's pretty nasty actually. But now he's wide open for Black Panther to go in. And he's stealthed as well, so he should take care of business. Yep. 5500 crit on the boss. I love my Black Panther for single target DPS. Oh, so good, so good. Black Widow doesn't really. Her ballerina doesn't really do it. Single target, as you can see here now. It did 2000 damage. It's awesome for AoE, definitely. But single target, not so much. Okay, let's see what happens here now. I completed the monocle. See the table here. See if I get the blue one. That would be really nice. Thank you. So long and thanks. No. Oh, I got a 4-star red. I can't complain on that actually. Evasion, speed and defense. Why couldn't you have accuracy instead of the defense, man? Sweet. Yeah. And that's the crosses are taken care of for good this time. Such a shame. They had so much potential. Superiors and just reading the text here. Now that I've finished Spec Group 1, I think you're one of us. An Avenger level badass. Humor is awesome, man. Okay, now let's finish the task. Claim. Ant-Man unlocked. Ant-Man recruited. Way. And there is where I'm gonna leave it off. That was Spec Ops 1, task 17 and 18. And as always, if you have any feedback, leave it in the comment sections below. And don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, have a good game.